you look at those costumes? Yeah, this is definitely made by the same crew. Made from those inflatable air dancer things you see outside stores. Oh, they must have borrowed them from Emperor Greg's used car lot. No doubt about it. If the director was good at anything, he was figuring out how to do things as cheap and cheesy as can be. Children in those suits. Or did they actually cast a bunch of little people? Casting call, 3-foot-tall actors needed. Must be okay with exploitation and standing around in a poorly ventilated paper mache suit all day.
Disruptor in action? It contradicts everything we understand about flight.
The phenomenon is a strange one indeed. But what are you getting at?
By studying your language, we've discovered there are some sounds which cannot be uttered. It's taken our elders many generations to create a list of these magic words. Please, take this tablet and read it in a loud, clear voice.
What trickery is this? It's nothing but a list of curses and foul language.
You see, even you can't speak the magic words.
I most certainly could. I just choose not to use such vulgarity.
Then the second artifact upholds the prophecy. Tread carefully. The others will try to destroy you.
Yes, about that. Why are the other aliens trying to kill us?
The others fear you, chosen ones. You have the power to alter reality. The naysayers want to silence you.
Oh, I get it. With their G rating, they weren't allowed to swear in the movie. Mix of monsters is one of the high points of the film. It's not like there's any consistency between all these B-movie monsters, but they somehow steal the show. Big snail there looks like my old Aunt Bertha. Bertha, looking pretty pale there. I'd sure cut off all the smoking, Aunt Bertha. It might kill you. Or, you know. Yep, another one for the deleted scenes. Hello there, Bertha. Looking pretty pale there. I'd sure cut off all the smoking, Aunt Bertha. It might kill you. Or, you know. That hero has got a pretty bad grudge against you.
Just my reflection. I've seen it dozens of times.
No. Gaze behind you.
Whoa, hey now! Who are all those people?
The great eye in the sky controls everything in our world. They must be its servants. We found one of their ancient scriptures.
The Deadly Tower of Monsters. The thrilling tale of Dick Starspeed's battle to overthrow the evil Emperor of Gravoria.
Every prophecy in the ancient scripture has come true. Only you can help us. Turn to page 63.
Production note. Is it too late to change Dick's name? A bit lacking, no?
No. Keep reading. The next section.
Final confrontation. The Emperor discovers the whereabouts of the native Gravorians and endeavors to kill them for more gold. Oh, that is what you were afraid of. Fear not, Gravorians. His ship has fallen, so surely
he
is...
At last, I have discovered the whereabouts of the native Gravorians. I shall endeavor to kill them for more gold! You! I shall turn you to gold and craft a tea set out of you! Better yet, I'll turn you into gold tiles for my bathroom floor! How dare you fight back! You will pay for this insolence! Soon your rebellion will be crushed. Quit! Such a nuisance! longer than I expected. But you're no match for my throne ship!
Some difficult actors before, but you are the worst. The set again. Don't you dare to... You've gone absolutely mad. Is this those damn method acting courses you've been taking? You want more money? You can't renegotiate your contract mid-shoot.
We don't want any more Gravorians or apes to die.
You... what?
You are in command of this world. We want you to seize these misfortunes.
Wait, let me get this straight. You want me to change the script? Fine, fine, I'll make the changes. So, the Emperor becomes a kind-hearted, generous man. Oh, and he loves puppies in the springtime. He frees the slaves, signs a peace treaty, yada, yada, yada. Bam! Everyone lives happily ever after. Okay, is that fine? Is everyone happy now?